We're in New Orleans delving into the food and music of the blues. And there's one meal that symbolises this more than any other, the PoBoy sandwich.
I'm a PoBoy, PoBoy.
We're on our way to try it at one of the best known places in town, the Parkway Bakery. The manager here is Justin Kennedy.
PoBoy is kind of a slang term, okay? The real name is PoBoy. PoBoy was during the Great Depression. The first PoBoy was potatoes and gravy. We still have that on the menu today. Wow. And it was a cheap, fulfilling sandwich, you know, and you could feed a family with it.
The name PoBoy is thought to have been coined at the start of the Great Depression in 1929, when the city's streetcar workers went on strike.
Former streetcar workers turned restaurateurs Benny and Clovis Martin decided to support the strikers by handing out free sarnies. But today, the PoBoy isn't just a poor man's food.
And there's certainly some rich boys that enjoy your PoBoys. I mean, Barack Obama comes here.
Oh, yeah.
Amazing.
The president came a couple of years ago. You'll have a near homeless fella sitting at the bar, rubbing elbows with a man with a $500 suit.
Yeah.
Eating the same damn sandwich.
Yeah.
Now, that shows you what kind of place it is. And like you said, the president came a couple of years ago.
Fantastic.
It feels like that sort of place. I mean, we're kind of new to all this, but you walk in and it's very inclusive. Everybody's very friendly and you just want to be fed. And that's why you come here.
It is.
Because it's the best place for PoBoys in New Orleans.
It is. And you go to some restaurants and it's just how it works. You go, some restaurants only cater to certain type of people, you know, whether it's certain ethnicity, certain... You know, money standard, a rich restaurant, a poor restaurant, you know. The good thing about here is everybody comes here. That's when you know you have something special, because it doesn't matter where you come from or who you are. It matters what is coming out of this joint.
Although the PoBoy originally contained potatoes and gravy, the most popular filling these days is fried seafood.
So, fellas, this is where the magic happens.
The engine room.
The engine room. This is our seafood station.
Right.
Louisiana shrimp, Louisiana catfish, and Louisiana oysters.
Unlike the UK, oysters are as cheap as chips here, and I love them.
Are they crusted in corn before you fry them?
Corn flour.
Corn flour.
It's a half and half mixture, and we spice it up. When you fry it up, the outside's crunchy, but when you open it, it's nice and juicy and moist and hot and delicious. And that goes with all three of the seafoods we have here.
I'm allergic to oysters.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but I'm really good with shrimp.
Okay. Okay. Well, man, I feel sorry for you. That ain't no good.
I know.
You gotta put some love in it when you're battered. Sometimes I sing to it, you know?
Yeah.
Summertime and the living is easy. Shrimp are jumping and the cotton is hot. There it is. Seafood's good for you. Fried seafood, anything fried's good for you. It's good for the mind and the soul. Might not be good for your heart. And these guys are ready.
Nice. Now that's a packed lunch.
These Parkway PoBoys are so popular, they sell an average of 7,000 a week.
Well, a PoBoy is something I've been eating all my life, even when I was a little fella. And I always think of a PoBoy as your seafood, your oyster, your shrimp, or your fish on the PoBoy bread.
It's really good. It's fully dressed with all the toppings and stuff like that. So it's really good.
Maybe with some pickles and a little hot sauce, but I always thought of mine what we call old fashioned, without lettuce, tomatoes, etc. That's something of a newer vein.
It gets everywhere, like you need 5 napkins, and the flavor is just awesome. Like you'd have to try it to understand why it's so good.
Maybe a little mayo, as I would say mine is, and sometimes just the butter and pickle. Love old unhealthy butter.
Look at that, man.
Just look at the cross section of a PoBoy. It's generous, it's spicy. You got your greens, you got your salad, you got some of your 5 a day.
Yeah, PoBoy heaven. Come on.
You can just hear it taste good.
Mm. Oh, man.
I bet some of the old people in the neighborhood, they must have been coming here since they were kids.
Oh, yeah, I have people in there right now that are eating that have been coming here, come here every day, sometimes lunch and dinner.
In a neighborhood, that's what's important.
Right.
Because it gives that neighborhood a level of identity and a level of place and purpose, doesn't it?
Correct.
Hurricane Katrina had a huge impact here, didn't it?
Had a very huge impact all night. Here on this corner, we got about 6 foot of water. And it was crazy with the storm, wiped everybody out.
and me and my uncle and one of the main guys, Chef James Adams, got this place reopened.
There must have been 2,000 people in the city at that time. And the day we opened, there was 2,500 on this corner.
Oh, yes! Hey. That's when you know you're on a winner.
It's an amazing, amazing place, Justin, and thank you so much for sharing it with us today.
No problem.
Because they're just, it's great.
Well, the poor boys thank are good. You. Really good.
Thank you.
We want to make our own tribute to the poor boy.
But instead of seafood, we're making a sloppy roast beef filling, which is cheaper our side of the pond.
We're down here in the Delta.
Okay, now this is about a kilo of chuck, and we've got two of these. You need to cook it for a long time, but it goes tender and it just falls apart.
That's a lot of beef for one sandwich, though, mate.
You've got to be kidding, though, but look it. Look at the size of that baby. That is the poor boy that we're going to fill.
Are you doing meat? I'll do veg.
Right, done.
I need two carrots, a couple of sticks of celery, and a big old onion.
Trim the excess fat off your beef.
And chop up your veggies nice and fine.
Okay, so we're going to season it, and then we're going to put it into a hot pan and sear it off. You want it over a medium heat. So each side, you want about 3 minutes, okay?
It's now impossible not to leer at the steer.
Getting there.
Yep.
Needs a bit longer. That'll do us, I think.
Aye!
Look at those joyful lumps of flesh.
Oh, yes. Right, now let's get the carrot to see the dripping.
Into the juices, throw in your chopped veggies and grate in two or three cloves of garlic and leave to sweat.
Baby's just blood, sweat and tears.
Now, this you sprinkle like pebble dash in a council house over the beef.
Look at that.
Pebble dashing.
Now deglaze the pan with half your beef stock. Then pop into bay leaves.
And thyme finely chopped. And then, Mr. Miles,
the rest of the stock. Same colour as the Mississippi, that. Wrap it tightly in foil. We don't want any of that gravy to escape into the ether. Pop this into a preheated oven, 140 degrees Celsius. That's a low oven, for about 3 hours. The time has come.
Oh!
The beef is done.
Transfer this.
Flesh. That's falling apart.
Oh!
Sorry. It's just one of them things. Beyond that, no, was it?
Gravy is wonderful, isn't it?
It's the great thing of the world.
Juice.
Wherever you go, you can always find a good gravy. Look at this. Look how tender this is. Watch this. Look at that.
I'm going to put a tablespoon corn flour or cornstarch. And mix this with a tablespoon of English mustard powder. Add two or three tablespoons of water, put this into the simmering gravy, and stir it until it's cooked out, and it will go thick. It's beefier than a bull in a liquidizer, that. We need to just drizzle an appropriate amount onto the beef.
Yep.
And then build our butty. Now the build. And there are certain conventions with poor boys, and that is the use of mayonnaise and pickle. What you have to be careful about with a poor boy is you want the same level of satisfaction in every bite. A mustard stripe. As you can see, there's no butter. Horseradish. Are you going to do the beef down one side?
I certainly am.
Now, on the other side, we've got cos lettuce and some rocket.
Poor boy is a nicely packed sandwich.
Whatever's in your poor boy, you inevitably have dill pickle and tomato. More like gardening than cooking this, isn't it, really? And it's top to bottom.
Two-hander. One, two, and go.
Go. All that remains to do now is to cut it into tasty portions. Look at that. A cross-section of a sloppy beef poor boy. Our tribute to New Orleans and the blues, the sloppy roast beef poor boy.
Back of the net.